Yeah, so Simon Hanlon is, he's an Irishman, and he's an architect. He's in his late 40s, and he lives in New York. He's living in Brooklyn in New York. And he left, I actually, myself, used to live in New York, and I knew a lot of Irish people, and I would probably include myself in this, who wanted to leave Ireland. You know, so a lot of the time we write immigration books about someone who had to leave Ireland. But he's actually, he's someone who wanted to escape from his past, which was, he grew up in Northern Ireland around the time of the Troubles. And so he's moved to Brooklyn, he's married a French woman, and he's kind of living a new life there. He gets divorced, and he starts having epileptic seizures in his late 40s. And these seizures kind of force him to start thinking about his past and his childhood. And when he was 15 years old, he was present at an IRA bombing, which happened in Enniskillen, which was near his hometown. It's also known as the Remembrance Sunday bombing, which is where the title comes from. And so basically he began having seizures after this bombing. So the seizures in his later life is causing him to come back to that earlier time and kind of examine his childhood and how those events came about. So I'm sure most of your readers will be familiar with the IRA, which was a terrorist organization in the north of Ireland. And they were a Republican organization who wanted Irish rule for the entire island, so that Northern Ireland, as we know, is still ruled by Britain. So they were a terrorist organization who would enact kind of political bombings. So the Remembrance Sunday bombing was very particular because it was at the end of the 1980s. So history has kind of told us that it was at the end of the Troubles. The peace process came, I think, about 10 years later. But this bombing was very specific in that civilians were deliberately targeted. So it was a day of remembrance for the troops, the British troops who had died in the World Wars. The bomb was planted in a schoolhouse, basically, just off the main street. But it was planted with the awareness that civilians would be standing in front of the wall in the morning when the bomb exploded. And it was also on a timer. A lot of terrorist bombings or IRA bombings would have been remote controlled, so they could control the blast and they could give a warning. But this one was on a timer, so they knew exactly when it would explode, and it was designed to basically kill citizens. Yeah, I suppose my answer to that is to say I didn't intend on writing a historical novel. I didn't intend on writing a novel about the Troubles. I really wanted to write about Chinatown, actually, because I was living in New York at the time, and I found it. I find Chinatown one of those areas that I imagined New York to be. It was like just extraordinary, interesting, and detailed, and really gritty. But New York of today is quite airbrushed, actually, and it's certainly Manhattan is quite wealthy and airbrushed. So it was an area that I was really interested in, and I was writing about an Irish character living there. I would spend a lot of time in Chinatown and found his apartment, you know, and really kind of spent a lot of time like thinking about the streets and the atmosphere of the place. And he happened to be, basically I didn't want to do a lot of research, so I decided to make him from Ireland. And I decided to make him from Northern Ireland, so he'd be a little bit separate to me, that I wouldn't be writing about myself. And gradually, as I started to write into this character, I knew that he would have been about 15 years old when the Enniskillen bombing happened. I did mention it very briefly in the first draft, but that no more than that. And then after a while, I realized that I was avoiding writing about the Troubles, and that was the thing that I needed to write about. So, I think writing about these kind of collective, moments of history that are shocking and that are resonating, I think you can throw light on the entire society. So I think that's part of the reason maybe that I'm writing about it. But I think, especially with this book, I think it just emerged as I went along.